warning that this video does include spoilers for Dungeon Meshi. But ever since I first saw the visuals for Kimura Falin, I've wanted to find some way to make a doll version of her. Eventually, I decided that I wanted to make a doll that was more inspired by her Kimura form, kind of eliciting the wings, eliciting the feathers and the dragon body without making a full-on dragon doll. For this project, I decided to use a Wild Hearts crew doll. I also used this doll for my Jobu Tobake doll from a few years ago. I really like using her for characters that are not super skinny. It requires me to sand down the bra and panties that are molded onto her body, but in general, I really like this doll mold. I am making use of some pretty old epoxy clay here. This project actually used up the last of a set of clay that I've been working with for many years at this point. I was definitely exploring as I went for building out the feet with clay. There were a couple times where I kind of changed my mind about how I approached it and lengthened out the foot and tried to make the proportions correct. In general, this is kind of my approach for crafting in general, is to just kind of try out things and see if it feels right, and if it doesn't, then try a different approach or try to modify it in some way. I wanted to add some texture to the legs at this point, so I mixed Mod Podge with white paint. That way I would have the thickness I needed to kind of build up a texture, and also I could have a flat color along the legs that would then make it easier to paint red later on. And then I'll be mixing up pastels to try and get a tone that I think will work well for Falin. Joints are always the tough part when it comes to painting or shifting color on a doll. So I'm trying out just doing pastels for the joints for now, and then putting on sealant before I do the actual paint for these legs. In the end, the sealant still gets kind of moved around when you bend the joints, so it's not a perfect solution. It does at least help so there's not such a jarring difference between the painted legs and the joints. start with the face up. At this early stage, I'm mostly just worried about placement, figuring out where are the eyelids, where are the eyes placed, and then as I go through further iterations, after I've figured out the placement how I want, that's when I'll start really kind of rendering it out. You'll notice here that I ended up kind of going over the work I had done on the eyes, and that was partly because I wanted to work out the shading of the whites of the eyes and also kind of shift the placement of the eye. But I had generally learned what I wanted the eye to look like through that earlier iteration, so I would just kind of come back to it after I had figured out the rendering of the whites of the eyes. And of course, we can't finish a doll's look without a little bit of shimmer in the eyes. So for Falin's feathers, I really wanted to do some crochet work. I'm still very new to crochet, so I will leave some kind of links below for tutorials that helped me kind of decide how I wanted to approach this. There's no exact pattern for what I'm doing here, so much as I'm just kind of feeling it out. I ended up often alternating between double crochets or half double crochets depending on how big I wanted the ruffles to be, but it was really a lot of just kind of feeling it out until I got the effect that I wanted from the crochet. So then she's got a neck ruffle, some ruffled shorts, and then I kind of made a representation of her wings that I'm actually really proud of. I think they have a lot of charm to them. They're more like a train than wings themselves. And then the tail. I will put down a link below that was really helpful for me to figure out how to do dragon scale style. It's not too different than what I was doing for the ruffles, but it's at a different angle. And again, I would kind of vary the stitch depending on how large I wanted the scale to be. Thank you. And then to help give the tail some bend, I'm taking a piece of wire, and then I'll cover it in yarn so that just to give a little bit of body to the tail inside of the crochet. To paint the legs. In order to do my best to match the colors of the yarn I used for the tail, I pulled out every color of red that I had. the life of me, I could not find my black paint. And the sensible thing would have been to mix up some black with the paints I already had, but then I just found this paint pen and I made it make do. I wanted to render out the red of the legs a little bit more with some deeper colors, so I pulled out my broader selection of pastels. Normally I wouldn't really use water with the pastels like this, but I wanted to bring out as much of the pigment as possible, especially since, I mean, the reason that you would usually avoid using water with pastels is that it makes kind of an inconsistency, but since I wanted that textured look, I wasn't particularly worried about that in this case. The hair part of a doll is probably one of the more difficult parts of doll crafting for me. This took maybe 3 tries to get right for this doll, so the crafting that you see here is not necessarily the final version, but it is kind of the process that I go through with building out the doll hair. I used yarn here because I wanted it to look natural and also to have kind of a fluffy look to it, somewhat akin to the way Falin looks in the manga and the anime. Now we can assemble. this project, I really tested out some new skills, and I'm happy with how the final result came out. I hope she elicits the Kimura Falin for you at least a little bit, and I hope you've enjoyed following the process of making her.